Hello everyone. Here we are having a question. The figure given below shows, figure means this graph, the variation of R, resistance, XL, you know, inductive reactance, XC, you know, inductive capacitance with frequency F for a series LCR circuit. The circuit will be inductive for the frequency point A, B, C, and D. I hope in this figure or the graph, you can see that there are the three frequency points. This axis is actually the frequency and there are three points A, B, and C. And we need to tell at which frequency the circuit will start behaving like a inductive circuit. As you all have covered the LCR series circuit, so I would like to let you know that during the topic LCR series circuit, we have gone through all the three cases, when the circuit behaves like an inductive, when the circuit behaves like capacitive, and when the circuit behaves like a resistive circuit, right? So right now in this case, they have told us to find out the frequency point at which the circuit will start behaving like an inductive circuit, right? So you know very well, the circuit will behave like an inductive circuit when XL is greater than XC. This is for inductive circuit. And what about the capacitive circuit? It will be when XL is less, but XC is greater. This is the condition for capacitive circuit, right? Let me write it. And this is the condition for, this is the quite popular condition. I know that each one of you know about that. XL is equals to XC. This is called the resonance condition. Or you can also say this is the condition at which the circuit behaves like a purely, sorry, my mistake. It should not call it purely. It should be resistive circuit. Resistive circuit. But right now we just have to focus at this point. That is XL is greater than XC. Out of all these frequency, actually the option D is D, and I could not be able to locate the point D in this graph. So you could be sure that D should not be the option of this question, right? So let's focus on these three points, A, B, and C. As you can see at point B, you can see both the XL and XC curves are going to intersect each other at this point B. So you could be sure that XL is equals to XC and the resonance condition at the point B. So we can say at the frequency B, there will be a resonance condition and the circuit will behave like a resistive circuit. But let's focus ourselves on the inductive circuit because right now here it will give the answer of this question. So you can see at inductive circuit, the value of XL must be greater than XC. So let me draw some quick lines so that you would be able to understand it better. At point A, let's talk about at point A. At point A means the frequency which is having at point A, we are having two graphs. This one, this point, I'm interested in this point and this point. Why these two points? Because these are the two points which will give us XL and XC, right? You can see very well that here it is the value of, this graph is going to intersect at the XC curve. So this is XC and this graph is XL, right? Yes, I know that this graph also intersecting the resistance, but we are not interested in that thing. That's why XL and XC is here. As you can see, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, and so on. So you can see that XC is greater than XL, but we are not looking for this thing, right? So it means that at this point A, or the frequency at A, XC must be greater than XL. So this frequency corresponds to capacitive circuit. This one corresponds to resistive circuit. And the last one, you know, this would be the answer. This is resistive circuit. Let me write down. This is resistive circuit. This is capacitive circuit. I know the last one will be the inductive circuit, but still I would like to let you know how this is inductive circuit. Let me delete this thing. Yeah, here it is. So let me draw the line, quick line. As you can see at this particular point, XL is having this value and XC is having this value. And you can see that XL is greater than XC. So we can see XL is greater than XC. That's why the frequency at point C corresponds to, the frequency at point C corresponds to inductive circuit. Sorry, once again, it is not purely because it is an LCR series circuit. Purely inductive circuit will be called when there is just an inductor and no capacitor or resistors are included. So right now, the correct answer of this question is C. I hope you got it. Thank you very much.